गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट, माई सेल्फ कौसर मोमिन, 8th स्टैंडर्ड, सब्जेक्ट साइंस, चैप्टर नंबर 7, मेटल्स एंड नॉन मेटल्स. सो बिफोर टू स्टार्ट दिस चैप्टर वी हैव टू डिस्कस फ्यू पॉइंट्स और वी कैन कंसिडर एज फ्यू क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड दिस चैप्टर. यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड अबाउट दिस क्वेश्चन. वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, वट आर द थ्री टाइप्स इन विच the elements are generally classified, and the three types are metals, non-metals and metalloids. Next question is, what are the metals and non-metals that we use in everyday life? So do you have any idea about metals and non-metals? So obviously we have a very nice idea for the same. If we will discuss about this metals and non-metals, so for the same answer is, we have in our surrounding objects, or we can say as materials, okay, and these materials are made from elements, compounds or their mixture. Whatever the materials or objects we are observing in our surrounding, so they are made from elements, compounds, or we can say it as mixtures, which we have seen element, compound and mixture also. So scientists classify all the elements into three general types, and the types are metals, non-metals and metalloids. Let's go ahead with the very first part, which is metals. So here is first part, and that is metals. Let me read this part first of all, then I will explain you while reading, okay? Gold, silver, iron, copper, aluminium, magnesium, calcium, sodium, platinum are few metals. Let me show you picture of the same. So you can observe on the screen, if you will see over here, you can see these pictures are of types of metals only. So let me show you the name for the same. This is copper, obviously you must have seen in your everyday life, okay. This is mercury, zinc, tungsten, silver. The ornaments are making from silver, a pile or in hand ring you're using silver rings, right? Titanium, magnesium, tin, steel, lead, aluminium. With the door and all, aluminium is used over there for the construction of door, for the latches and all, aluminium used over there. Okay, so we can see all these are the types of metals. So if you can observe this screen, these are the ornaments, we can say, which is gold ring. It is a part of metal only. Coin, nail, silver spoon, iron copper clips, which we are using for the paper clips. This is steel ruler, needle, safety pin. Every day we are using this, and these are the pins. So you must have seen all these things which you are using in your everyday life. All these are the types of metals. All this comes in a metals only. Here are the few examples, few parts of metals, how metals we are using. So copper wires, this is nickel, steel pipes, tin, lead and zinc. The images which I have shown you, all the parts of metals only, we can say gold, silver, iron, copper, aluminium, magnesium, calcium, sodium, platinum. These are the few metals. Metals have luster. The metals are hard, wire or sheet can be from them made metal. As I have shown you in diagrams also, the photo which I have shown you on the screen, you must have seen over there, wire or sheet can be made from metal only, because it has that characteristics, we can say it has that property. We can make a plate, we can make a wire from same, okay. So metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. You must have seen in the wires, which wire present in it, obviously copper is there. So we can say it is a good conductor of heat and electricity. Metals, obviously you must have seen whatever the utensils are there, they are metals only. Metals lose their valence electrons to produce positively charged ions, that is cations. If you will go in detail with the study of these metals with respect to electricity and all, then they can lose their electron very easily and they can accept the positive charges and it has become cations. This study we can study in detail in your next class. Next level of your class. Okay, now we will go ahead with the physical properties of metals. Very first property is physical state. Under ordinary temperature, metals stay in solid state. However, metals like mercury and gallium are exception, which are in liquid state even at room temperature. If you will go ahead with this metals, then all metals are in a solid state with a specific temperature. Obviously, if you will increase a lot of temperature, then definitely it will convert it into liquid only. But in natural at room temperature, only two metals are there. They are in a liquid state, and the metals are mercury and gallium. This type of question will be there for MCQs. Which metals are there in liquid state at room temperature? So answer is mercury and gallium. Okay. Next is luster. Take copper vessels at your home, scrub them with lemon and rinse with water. You must have done this part also, otherwise your mom has done this part while washing the utensils. She is for the whichever the specific metals like copper, iron metals are there, she is using lemon to wash it out, and after rinsing it, it will gives you a shine. Okay, so observe the luster before and after cleaning. Light gets reflected from the clean or freshly cut surface of metal, and metal looks lustrous. So you must have seen this type of things at home also. This physical property. Next property is hardness. Generally, metals are hard. Obviously, you must have seen with your iron, they are very hard and they are not obviously soft. Exceptions, sodium and potassium are soft, can be easily cut by knife. If you will consider sodium and potassium, they are also a part of metal, but they are very soft. This type of question is also there, like which metal... They are very soft. There can be a question which metal is soft. So you should know the idea for the same. Soft metal is sodium and potassium. Next is ductility. Have you ever gone to a goldsmith shop? Have you seen the goldsmith making a wire of gold or silver? When a metal is pulled through a hole, its wire is formed. This property of metal is called as ductility. Means whatever the metal is there, we can form a very thin wire from the same. Because of that only from gold we are making ornaments and all, and you must have seen the chain and all is formed by the same, and the shopkeeper is making the sonar, he is making a very long wire from the gold and he is making from the same chain. Okay, so we can make it, pulled it out, and we can make a wire by this gold. This is the basic example for the same. So that is comes since ductility. Next is malleability. Take an iron nail, place it on a platform and keep on hammering it. After some time, you will see a thin sheet forming. This property is called as malleability of metals. Like whatever the roofs and all, the iron roofs, they are having very flat surface. And because of the flat surface, we are using on our terrace and all. So this is a part of malleability. Like if you will hammer on it, then it will get spread it out and you will get a plain sheet.
like very thin sheet.
To understand in detail for malleability and ductility, please see this video. The malleability condition is forming over here. After hammering, the flat surface is going to come. You can read the part which is given in down of the screen. See, the surface gets coming flattened. Forming of nails, iron nails we can say. This is the finished product. Now ductility, from this thick rod we are going to make a thin wire that comes in a ductility. You can observe the process for the same. There is a process. So we can say this type of things will be there. We can make a wire from the iron, so that is ductility. We can stretch and we can make a thin it out, so we can give this name as ductility, this process as ductility. You can observe here clearly, and we can say by the end of the process the 1 centimeter thick rod has been reduced to about 2 millimeter in diameter. You can observe how much thin it is. Okay, so here the wire is there, this much ductility is there. Next is conduction of heat. Take a copper plate, fix some wax at one of its end, heat the other end and observe what happens. So obviously it will get melt. So we can say that metals are good conductors of heat. Silver, copper, aluminium are the best conductors of heat. Hence we are having whatever the utensils, they are forming aluminium, silver and aluminium, copper and silver also. But nowadays silver is very costly, that is why we are not using this type of utensils. Let's go ahead with the another level, another form. Point number 7, conduction of electricity. So in electrical wires, which metal is there? Have you ever seen about it? Ask your parents, might be they know the answer for the same. If they don't know, then let's go ahead with it. Metals are good conductors of electricity. Lead is an exception, because lead is also a part of metal, but it is not good conductor of electricity. That is why lead is an exception. Which is neither a good conductor heat or good conductor of electricity. Lead is not a good conductor of electricity and not a good conductor of heat. Okay, next is density. Metals have high density. Sodium, potassium, lithium are exception. Like sodium, potassium and lithium, they are not having high density. Rather than that, another metals are having very high density. So the density of lithium is only 0.53 gram per cc. Next is sonority. What is the metal that your school bell is made of? How does a bell is function? Metals are sonorous. They produce sound on striking. If we will hit on each other again and again, then obviously it will create a sound which is in our school. So that is why we are using for the bell. So it will create a sound, hence it is known as sonority. Okay. Now next is non-metals. Carbon, sulfur, phosphorus are few non-metals. Generally non-metals are brittle and non-lustrous. That means they will not give you a shine. Okay. I stop my video over here. Your homework is, you have to read and write this physical properties of metals, which is very, very important every physical property you must should know about it, because it is very important. If you'll know, if you'll get the idea for the same, then you are able to understand easily for difference between metals and non-metals. First of all, learn and write the properties of metals.